Hey guys, welcome back to my channel WePlay. And in today's video, we are going to have a look at the reserve run and the second part of that particular video. I have already posted a part one of this video. You can go ahead and check it out if you have already missed that. And in this video, I will discuss the other loot points and the places where you can loot and how to get out of reserve safely as well. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started with the video. So we are going to start from this location. This is the dorm right here. We have covered all of this area over here in the first part. Now in this video, I'm going to show you all the loot runs and the keys required for this side of the video. We'll go ahead and have a look at the first location, which is the extract, which is the manhole extract right here, where you need to drop your bag in order to extract from here safely. This is used in terms of emergencies. Next, this is White Knight, and this is the long garage attached to it. This is White Knight right here, and this is Black Knight right on the opposite side. So the first place that we are going to look at is the RBST building. So this is a locked room, and you will require a key, which is the RBST key. So make sure that you have a look around before opening the gate over here, as many PMCs rush to this place as well. So inside you can find many different types of loots available. So there are some weapon attachments and bullets available all around in this particular area. There are two grenade cases also. There are some weapon attachments or weapon parts available, and there are some weapon crates as well. So make sure to look around in this particular place, as there are a lot of loot where you can go ahead and snatch from this particular place. So we'll go ahead and move on to the next place. So this is the long garage, which is connected to White Knight right over here, and that is Black Knight on the opposite end of this particular building. Make sure that you are careful around this particular place, as Blueheart does spawn over here as well. He can spawn in any one of these buildings, so make sure that you have a look around before entering the building, or you can get shot down very fast. This is the second room which you need to have a look, and you need to have a key for it. Once you open this particular gate, there are some loose loot around here as well, and you can find a documents case spawn on the desk or on the chair as well, so make sure that you have a look around. There is a paracord spawn over here as well, so make sure you have a look at this particular room. There is another room which is situated right here. You will need a key for it, which is the MP21 key. So make sure you have a look in this as well, as you can find tank batteries inside. Make sure that you go ahead and have a look all over on the third floor as well, as there are some loose loots and jackets on the top floor, and 4 PC cabinets on the top floor as well. So make sure you have a look around before going into the terrace area. As you can see, there is White Bishop behind us, or the King's building behind us, and this is the long garage over here. So we'll go ahead and have a look at White Knight as well. So this is also a place where Gluhar spawns, which is the White Knight or the Black Knight. So make sure you go ahead and look around. He spawns usually in this location, and this is a locked room which you need a key for. So once you open this, you can go ahead inside, and there are some loose loot right here where is important, and you can find some of the attachments over here as well on the desk, and there is a documents case spawn as well on this. So make sure you have a look around before entering any other rooms, and we can go ahead and have a look ahead as well. So we can enter this building through this break in the wall or through the long garage right here, and we will go ahead and have a look on the upper floor as well. So this floor is blocked and can only be entered from the terrace of this particular building, and you can go ahead and have a look all around this particular place. So this is where you can find food ration and all the different stuff. There is a PC cabinet right here. There is more duffel bag and food ration in this room. And over here you can find different types of weapon attachments all over this place. I have even found a Reap IR in this particular room or a FLIR attachment as well. So make sure you have a look at this particular place as it can be very valuable and it has a weapons case inside as well. So make sure you have a look around and then we can go ahead on the terrace area. So there are two drop downs in this particular area. Be careful not to fall down from this particular place, as if you go through here you will break your legs and you will end up straight in the main entrance of this particular place. So make sure you don't jump from this area and you go in this particular place where is the locked room which we are looking for. And there are some attachments on the terrace as well. And once you go down here, this is the room that you need to look at, as it is a locked room and all the other rooms have weapon attachments or food supplies in the room as well. So have a look at this particular room as it can be very valuable. And there is an entry exit from this place as well. So you don't need to particularly jump from the terrace, as you can enter from this place as well. So this is the location for the E2 bunkers and this is the train station right here. So we'll go ahead and have a look at this train station as well, as Gluhar also spawns in this area. And once you switch on the power switch, there are some of the raiders who spawn in this place as well. So be careful when you're around here and you can find a lot of loot as well. There are a lot of PMCs who also camp this particular area as they need to kill highly geared raiders as well. So make sure you look around before moving about in this particular place. This is the backside of the reserve area and this is the bunker where you can also extract. So this is the bunker area where you require the 4 keys and there is a Gluhar spawn and raider spawn inside. So make sure you look around all over this place before entering. And if you have a teammate, please be together as raiders can take you down really quickly. There are 4 locked rooms in this particular basement area which you need to have a look at. So this is the PSP1. This is a highly looted place in reserve, as you get a lot of crates and ration crates, and I've also found tank batteries inside. This is the PSP2 where you find all the medical supplies. This is also a good place for technical and ration crates in this particular room, which is the PS81, and this is the PS82. So make sure you have a look all over this place, as there are very good spawn locations inside these particular crates. So do make sure that you go ahead and have a look inside this place as well. I will show you some of the other locations where you can find good loot as well. So first we'll go ahead, and this is the place which is the most looted one, where you need to have a look and always loot this particular place. And the PS81 is the most expensive key that you can find at this point of the stage, as it spawns the highest amount of good loot in that particular room. This is also a good place to find some fuel and fuel conditioners over here as well. So make sure you have a look around here as well. So this is the PS81 room which you need to have a look into. So I've already had the key, so I'll open up and I will show you inside as well. So over here, once you open up the crate, there is which type of crate it is. It will show you on the top right hand side. This is a medical supply crate. As you open up the crates, it will always inform you which kind of crate it is. As over here it is written a ration supply crate, and over here it is a technical supply crate. So make sure to have a look around and know what kind of crate you are looting. And once you're done, you can go ahead and exit from any one of these sides, as they all connect to the train station above. So I will go ahead and take this route and come out on this side of the train station. So this is where we entered the train station, that is the bunker area. And we will go to the main train station where we have an extract as well, which is the train extract. So armored train extract, and we will, this is the place where the armored train comes in the last 15 minutes of the map. It can come early or late as well, so make sure you are in and around this particular area if you wish to extract from the armored train. There are a lot of loot areas over here as well, but make sure that you don't make a lot of noise in this particular area, as can be heard very easily, and PMCs rush to this place as well. So make sure you go ahead and don't make a lot of noise when you are in this area about. I will show you one of the best place to loot, which is a marked room right here. So when you are at the backside of the train station, this is the place where you need to go head into. It is a commonly rushed spot from for PMCs, as it has a marked room and a weapons crate room. To make sure, if you spawn in and around this particular area, you need to rush to this particular place, as you can find good loot in this marked room. So this is the marked room, as I can find two of the guns, which is the SVDS and the SV98 in this particular place. You can find anything that is available, which is the rarest of the items, which is the dog case, dog tag case, all the other medical boxes and the other stuff as well. So make sure that you go ahead and have a look in this room. And then after you have looted this room, you can go on the opposite side, which is the weapon attachments or the weapon room. Once you head inside, you can find fully kitted AKs also with suppressor, and you can find the attachments on this particular table as well. This is a very good room to loot if you are doing a minimal amount of run where you're not wearing sufficient gear and you're just carrying a pistol. You can head into this room, get yourself an AK, and go about with the raid as well. So make sure you go ahead in this room. Next, on the bunker side, we are going to have a look inside the bunker where the extract is located. So over here, this is the whole of the train station right here, where the armored train arrives, and over here, which is the K buildings, where Luhar spawns the most. So have a look around, as this is a highly looted place, and those are the E2 bunkers right there. So make sure you go ahead and have a look around, as raiders spawn in this particular area as well. And I will show you where you can loot inside the extract as well. So I will firstly show you the extract location. So once you switch on the power, this light turns green and you can go ahead and extract from this particular location right here. So once you do that, you can extract from the map, but it gives you roughly 4 minutes or so for till the power stays on, and then it automatically turns off. So make sure you, if you are going ahead and switching on the power, make sure that you rush to this place immediately, or else the extract will shut down. So there are some loot places that you can loot right here. There are some fuel canisters and fuel that you can find in this particular room. At the very end, you will also find some of the weapon attachments or the weapon crates as well. So make sure to have a look at those as well. There are two in this particular room, and people also camp this particular area, as it is an extract as well. So make sure that you look around before going straight into the extract, as people can shot you down, take your loot and extract successfully. So have a habit of looking around before rushing towards the exit, as you can become an easy target as well. So there is a weapons crate here as well, and a grenades case also. You can find some loose ammo on this particular crate as well. So if you are running low on ammo, you can go ahead and have a look here as well. And we will go in the last area where we entered the bunker place, and there are some paracord spawns right here as well. So make sure to have a look around before exiting the place. So once you had a look around, you can go ahead and I will take you to the very end location, where this is the heating pipe area where you can extract as a scav. This is the dorm right here, and this is the K buildings right behind that. This is the spawn area where the PMC spawn in the start of the map. And this is also one of the extract right here, which is the scav land extract, where you need a friendly scav in order to extract from this location successfully. If you have done so, you will also get a reward from Fence as well, as he will give you a random loot into your inventory if you extract with a friendly scav successfully. So have a look around in this area as well, as there are some weapons and weapon attachments that you can find all over this particular place. And this is the last area where you need to look at in order to go ahead and you can extract from this reserve map. And there are no more locations which are there in this reserve loot which will give you the good loot that you're looking for. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to hit the like button and to subscribe to my channel, as I come up with new guide videos every week. If you have any questions regarding it, you can go ahead and write it down in the comment section below. And I will see you in the next one.